At first glance, the lemon seems simple, bright, sour, familiar. But what happens when we slow things down? When we look not just at the lemon, but inside it? Welcome to Up Close, a channel where we look at the everyday, the overlooked, and the ordinary through an extraordinary lens. We begin with the outermost layer, the skin. This isn't just a protective shell. It's a high-performance biological suit, engineered over millions of years to shield, signal, and survive. The lemon skin is composed of two layers, the flavido, thin, pigmented, and rich in essential oils, and the albedo, or pith, the white, spongy layer, often discarded, but surprisingly valuable. Under magnification, we find tiny reservoirs, oil glands filled with limonene, a volatile compound that gives lemons their sharp, fresh scent. Limonene isn't just for aroma, it's antibacterial, antifungal, and has even been studied for anti-cancer effects. In nature, it warns off pests. In the lab, it's a compound of interest. The inner pith is rich in pectin, a soluble fiber used in food as a gelling agent, and in science for its effects on gut bacteria and blood sugar control. Even the skin of a lemon is full of function. Next, we move to the lemon's interior. Sample 2, the flesh. This part of the fruit is made almost entirely of juice vesicles, tiny, fluid-filled sacs that burst when squeezed. Under the microscope, the pulp becomes a city of cells. These are parenchyma cells, basic building blocks of plant life, and each one holds a watery solution of citric acid, vitamin C, and trace minerals. Vitamin C is crucial to human health. It's the reason lemons saved sailors from scurvy. And citric acid? It plays a key role in cellular respiration, part of the Krebs cycle where living cells turn nutrients into energy. When you bite into a lemon, you're triggering cell death, burst vesicles spilling their contents in a flash of flavor and function. Our final sample is the pure juice itself, sample 3. Though it may look like plain liquid, lemon juice is a complex solution. It contains water, yes, but also suspended organic acids, electrolytes, enzymes, and microparticles from ruptured cells. Its pH is around 2, making it highly acidic. That acidity doesn't just make it taste sharp, it gives lemon juice the power to preserve food, sterilize surfaces, and even conduct electricity. The famous lemon battery is proof that a fruit can be a power source.
Does that make any sense?
It's like sense, whatever you just said.
Light, heat, and air trigger oxidation, breaking down the molecules inside. When you put all three samples together, skin, pulp, and juice, you begin to see the lemon not as a food, but as a living system. Every part has evolved for a reason. The color attracts attention. The bitterness deters predators. The acidity preserves the seed-bearing flesh. It's biology, chemistry, and strategy, all in one compact package. The lemon is a product of thousands of years of cultivation, but its roots stretch back to ancient hybrids. A union of bitter orange and citron, cultivated first in Asia and carried across the globe by explorers, traders, and farmers. Even as it decays, the lemon teaches us. Microorganisms feed on the sugars. Acids break down tissues. It's not just rot, it's transformation. One life form becoming fuel for others. Nature in constant motion. So next time you slice a lemon, take a moment to look closer. It's not just sour, not just yellow, not just garnish. It's a vessel of chemical defenses, evolutionary advantages, historical cures, and endless curiosity. A whole universe contained in a single fruit. Thanks for watching Up Close. If you enjoyed diving deep into the lemon with us, consider giving this video a like and subscribing for more close-up explorations. And let us know in the comments, what should we zoom in on next?